the introduction of the compact disc was the big bang of the digital audio and video revolution. And I'm very glad that I could add more than 1,000 patterns to this revolution. At some moment in time, the director of the audio department came to our group and he said, "Oh, I like your video disc very much, but can you also make an audio-only disc?" But my highest boss said, "Oh, well, that's trivial. You can just switch off the video. Who cares about it?" So, to find a coding technology that's reliable and efficient is far from trivial. We had to do hundreds and thousands, maybe, of experiments to find the right one. The challenge with the compact disc is that the laser reads the information without actually touching it. The big thing in optical recording is the track following system. And just like with rowing in a canal or on a river, you need a coxswain to actually exactly steer the laser or the boat or whatever. It's just very similar. The number 8 plays a very important role in my life. In my professional life, 8 bits form a byte, and bytes are extremely important in coding technology. And in my leisure time, I row in an 8 and I love it very much. In 8014 modulation, 8 bits are transformed to 14 bits, and the 14 bits actually guarantee that you have a good track. So I invented EFM for the compact disc, and 10 years later I improved this code for the DVD. And for the third generation of optical recording, Blu-ray disc, I also improved the code another time. Now, 30 years later, we see digital everywhere in the world. Sound, video, data, everything is digital, and people really love it.